Welcome to part 2 of Flexible Assembly Systems Fastening Theory educational video. In this video, we will investigate friction factors and how they affect tightening. First, let's look at where all the torque we apply to a fastener goes. As discussed in part 1, the goal of tightening is to create clamp load. Clamp load is the force keeping two or more parts from separating from each other. There is one giant factor that prevents all the torque we apply from being translated into clamp force, and that is friction. Friction is the resistance that one surface or object encounters while moving over another. About 90% of the applied torque is spent overcoming friction, split between the threads and bearing surfaces of the bolted joint. Only about 10% of the applied torque in a joint is creating clamp load. There are many friction factors to overcome when fastening, and a few ways to change where the torque goes. The first factor are the tolerances of the parts involved. Bolts and nuts that are manufactured to a tighter tolerance are more likely to fit together smoothly and offer more consistent results than those made under looser standards. The next factor is alignment. When designing a joint, the path the fasteners take should be well aligned and prevent unnecessary rubbing or shearing when fastening the joint. A misaligned joint won't provide a consistent platform for tightening. Another factor is the surface finish on the mating parts. A sanded or polished surface will produce less friction than a brushed or textured surface would. The materials used also have a large impact on friction. Plastics and soft metals are much less rigid than steel or other hardened materials. Materials with lower frictional coefficients will have less resistance to each other and consume less torque. The type of lubricant and the amount used can also help alleviate friction that builds up between threads while tightening, if any lubrication is used at all. Special fastener types, such as thread-forming fasteners or nylon insert lock nuts, can introduce unique frictional factors that don't exist in standard fasteners. Other materials within the bolted joint, such as gaskets or soft objects, will exert their own resistance to being compressed. When designing a joint, all of these factors should be taken into consideration. It's important to maintain constant friction within the joint while it's being tightened. This will ensure the most accurate and reliable results. That concludes part 2 of our Flexible Assembly Fastening Theory educational video. Be sure to check out part 3, where we cover different types of torque tools and safety concerns with using them. Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, be sure to subscribe for more product news and updates from Flexible Assembly.